What's up, viewers, and welcome back to the channel. From the brand that brought you the Yugoos line of Android boxes brings to you a high performance mini PC at an affordable price. This is the SZBox S1 Alder Lake Intel N97 Windows 11 mini PC. And for only $109, this mini PC offers great performance, front LED display, hardware monitoring, and a great overall design. So let's take a look at what the S1 has to offer. My full review begins after this. So welcome back after that quick unboxing. And the contents of this package include the S1 mini PC, a magnetic holder for vertical positioning, one HDMI cable, a 12-volt 4 amps power supply, and a user manual. So this mini PC is designed to stand vertically with the included magnetic base. At the front, it has an LCD display and an RGB indicator on the lower section. Once you start and boot into Windows, you'll be able to configure what is displayed on the screen in terms of hardware monitoring. For connecting peripherals to its rear, it has two HDMI 2.1 ports, a pair of gigabit LAN ports, a headphone jack, its DC input socket, and a Kensington lock. At the top is where you will find two USB 3.0 ports, two USB 2.0, its power button, and its exhaust vent. To one side, you have a removable magnetic cover for quick and easy access to its 16GB 3200MHz DDR4 RAM module, its 512 NVMe M.2 SSD, and its additional NGFF M.2 slot for expandable storage. The side panel also has anti-skid rubber strips for horizontal positioning. And to its base, you have its intake vent, with vents also on the magnetic base. So I've booted into Windows, and under basic system information, it shows that its Intel N97 CPU has a base clock speed of 2.0 GHz. It has 16GB of RAM, and it's a 64-bit operating system. It's running on Windows 11 Pro version 22H2, and it's activated with a licensed Windows product key. For some more hardware details, Ada 64 Extreme shows that its CPU is the quad-core Intel N97 running at 2.9 GHz. It comes with 16GB of DDR4 RAM, and this is a single 16GB 3200 Silverica brand module. Its GPU is the Intel UHD Graphics 730 with a base clock speed of 300 MHz and a boost speed of 1300 MHz. Its audio adapter is the Intel Alder Point P HDMI that can play all surround sound audio formats. Its system disk is a BR512 NVMe M.2 SSD brand. Its Wi-Fi adapter is the Realtek 8852BE Wi-Fi 6 model, and its dual LAN ports are gigabit LAN ports. Pre-installed with your Windows installation are two applications, one for controlling the RGB lighting effects, and the other is for configuring the layout and orientation of the LCD hardware monitoring display. For Windows features, you get 4K display up to 60Hz, HDR display, 360 degrees screen rotation to portrait mode, reverse portrait and reverse landscape, wireless display. It has two HDMI ports to deliver dual extended monitor display. If you connect, and only when you connect to surround sound audio speakers or AV receivers, will you get the option under sound settings for 5.1, 7.1, Dolby Atmos and DTS:X. So I will now run through my list of videos and test for surround sound audio formats. So here it outputs Dolby Atmos.
The world's first object-based cinematic audio. With powerful moving audio that transcends from channels.
Next, it can do Dolby Digital Plus.
Pull your vehicle to the side of the road.
Whoa! What is this place?
It can process HD Master Audio. Dolby Surround from Dolby Vision Videos. It can output Dolby True HD. And DTS:X. So this mini PC can process all surround sound audio formats. If you install video extensions from the Microsoft Store such as HEVC, MPEG Layer 2, and AV1, you can play various types of 4K HDR videos. Here's a demonstration. But please note, mini PCs do not have an auto HDR feature, so you either turn it on or off. This is a 4K AV1 video with HDR. This is a Dolby Vision video. Here is Dolby Vision with Dolby Atmos. This is HDR 10 Plus. And this is HLG. And onto some gaming. So its GPU is in no way capable of handling games above 1080p resolution. So it's recommended that the highest you should attempt is 1080p at 60Hz for smooth gameplay. So this is Race Room Racing Experience on the Steam platform. And at 1080p resolution on a low to medium graphics settings, the game runs smoothly at 49fps. Anything above that drops to 14fps and the graphics rendering starts to struggle. Let's look at some benchmarks. I'll start with its RAM and internal storage speeds. It has a peak RAM transfer speed of 4703 MB per second. Its M.2 NVMe SSD has a sequential read speed of 1700 MB per second and a sequential write speed of 1470 MB per second. In testing its Wi-Fi and Ethernet LAN port speeds, I got some really good results. Where on its 5 GHz band, its 2.4 GHz band, and on its gigabit LAN port, based on my internet speed of 315 megabits per second, both Wi-Fi bands and the LAN port averaged over 300 megabits per second. In benchmarking, its CPU's single-core and multi-core performance, Geekbench 5 shows that it has a base clock speed of 2.0 GHz and a boost clock speed of 3.56 GHz. And the test results generated a score of 1,019 single-core and 2,602 multi-core. In benchmarking, its GPU's performance, in the TrueDMark Time Spy test, at 1080p, it averages less than 30fps, and at 1440p, it averages less than 20fps. And for all-in-one comprehensive benchmarks, in the PC version of the AnTuTu benchmark, it generated a score of 333,006. And in the PC Mark 10 comprehensive benchmark, it scored 3,240. This test also shows its web browsing score and its video editing score. So to make sense of these benchmarks, I've entered them on my rankings chart, and the SZBox S1 ranks at position 13, which is not bad at all for its chipset. If you would like to compare it to other mini PCs in this list, I placed a link in the description below this video. If you are interested in running alternative operating systems, it comes with an additional M.2 slot. However, this is where things start to get a bit disappointing. The additional M.2 slot can only read NGFF M.2 SSDs, which are currently being phased out for the new high-speed NVMe SSDs. If you attempt to install an NVMe SSD, the PC will not detect it. So you have to go looking for an older NGFF SSD to use on this PC. But that's not the only issue. When installing alternative operating systems, you have to create a bootable flash drive with the operating system installation. Unfortunately, the BIOS can only read flash drives 32GB and under. So if you have an SSD enclosure or an external hard drive that you would like to use as your installation disk, the BIOS will not detect it. Only when you use a 32GB and under flash drive, you can install your operating system. For alternative operating systems, I successfully installed the latest Android 13 x86 Bliss Zenith version 6.9.6. So, under Android x86, its CPU is clocked at 3.6 GHz and it's configured in 64-bit mode. It is running on Android 13 and its CPU idles around 52 degrees Celsius. It has excellent GPU performance for Android gaming, and it generated an AnTuTu score of 244,533. The only downside is that the firmware does not output audio through its HDMI ports by default, and its Bluetooth is not working. So in summary, the Intel N97 is touted as the king of budget CPU performance, and it has the benchmarks to prove it. It has a user-friendly design with its magnetic cover to access its internal components. It has silent fan operation, and its LCD hardware monitor display adds some modern flair to its design. A couple of things to take note of. It does not have a USB Type-C port. Its second M.2 slot is restricted to NGFF SSDs only, and its BIOS can only read installation disk 32GB and under. So I've come to the end of my review. If you are in the market for a high performance budget mini PC, remember the brand SZBox and take advantage of the low price of this S1 model. So if you are interested, see the link in the description below this video. Thanks for watching. Give this video the thumbs up if you enjoyed the presentation. If you like this kind of content, then I urge you to click the subscribe button and ring the notifications bell to receive notifications about new videos, open box deals, and giveaways. So stay connected and see you in the next one.